Dawn. I can see. Okay, it's not. It's not happening. I just want to say it before the lock-in just in case it was.
That would have been impressive. I would have been really impressed had they gone.
Gaming, when it comes to their kill participation, they are third in the league. This is a team that plays as a team, and Scout doesn't have his team around him right now. Knight gonna flash forward for the solo.
Really performing in this series, getting a solo kill there brings so much more confidence for them, and now a Scatter of the Week. Karst is here as well. This CC chain, and there's no flash available. Scout's gonna go down again.
Esports, and now they go under the tower. 369 will be happy to tank this one up as he pulls him in. Flash comes out from Flandre, but he can't
survive. To fall dramatically behind in this early game. They've got to shore up these weaknesses, but Duo won't let them as he goes in the bottom side. Mako the target here as he's burning down to the Ignite. Flash away as Karsa comes into the lane, but he's locked up himself. And this is a 2v3. Viper stacking up the shuriken. He looks for more as well. Viper wanting to prove himself as the best AD carry in the league, but he's knocked away, and Jackie Love now will survive. But Mako finds the hook. Cleanse comes on in. Mako wants to make the dive happen.
I mentioned that before. That's why it's so hard to be able to even gank him. And now top lane looks like another dive attempted.
Yeah, this one, another clean dive from top esports. And they're just going to slam a herald. They're like, you know what? Sod it. We're never going bot again. Jackie Love, Joe, you're on your own on the bottom side. We're just going to win top side of the map instead. Jackie Love suddenly realizing that he's very alone in the world. Had his flash, but there's no point at that stage. He's doomed. And you can see him shifting in his chair a little bit there. Two kills now for Viper. The tower goes down topside.
This is a smart call, though, for TES. Well, Jakulov might not be having that performance in the lane that we expected. At least on the other part of the map, it's going exactly to plan for top esports. They're getting so much gold into 369. Knight right now, 2-0-2 on that Syndra.
Top esports all about the skirmishes in the mid and the early game. JJ tries to get the steal there with an undertow. It's not gonna
happen. That lane, when you have an Alistar paired up with it, it's not your go-to plan that has to happen. You have insurance elves.
Yeah, and the Scat of the Week as well, being able to stop Scout, being able to operate in a lot of fights, if he can be in the right position. But that's the key thing. Scout has to just try and clear that wave, get out of the mid lane, and influence the game elsewhere. And well, with Viper now finishing off a second tower, and he'll get the plates as well. He's still got 15 seconds on the clock before the plates run out. Viper is getting huge. 15 seconds below where 369 is. Top esports, they want to go towards an inhib. Wait.
See if they can rotate in time. It's just Duo at the moment. It's going to be some time before the other members of top esports are there.
Oh, he's knocked him out of the pit. He's knocked JJ out of the pit. Duo, you absolute legend. He's going to be able to get in, gets the smite, and gets out on the Dark Express.
Couple minutes time here. And top esports know that, so they will just force themselves into this bottom lane. On towards Flandre they go, and you know,
Bellow's Breath will block one stun, but when there's 17 stuns coming your way, there's not a whole lot you can do about it. Flandre, he don't get to play League of Legends today.
That's the third time we've seen poor Flandre flank potentially. If you're able to get enough poke, you're going to be able to kill people. Bye, Flandre.
Flandre, no, not again. He does not get to do anything. Another
side of the map here. You can see Scout up in the top lane right there. He's just going to shove the wave in.
No contest. Start to push themselves. Actually, we've got 369 on a flank, pulling everybody in. Can they turn this into more of a fight, though? Because not much damage done just yet. There's 369 in trouble, but there's one going down. It's a pick onto Mako. Moonlight Vigil not really doing all of too much. Unless EDG can stop them. In they go. JJ, once again, the one that has to face Jake here. Scout of the Week goes in. Duo holding the trigger for now. Not willing to go in until he has a better knock-up. Scout goes in as well. Baron is going to be taking it. Top esports get this one for themselves. Is it going to be the team fight, though? Top esports could just opt out. They don't need to.
Duo on the flank as well, but he'll be denied by Scout, who gets a trouble bubble. Dragon goes down in this game so far. Had a really rough laning phase with Knight grabbing a solo kill.
Now JJ forced to flash out of the jungle as well. Karst are happy to just be a brick wall on the front line. Knight flashes the Moonlight Vigil. It was a close one with 369. He's 2v1ing on the back line. There's nothing Scout can do but flash away. Haymaker in onto the team. But it's actually going to be Duo pulled in and taken down. 4v5 on both AD carries. A good stun there onto Mako, but Knight could be in trouble. He doesn't have flash for himself, and the rest of the team needs to get in and protect him.
Uh-oh.
It's going to be Carter to go down, starting the fight. In goes 369 onto 5, but the rest of the team's not here. In comes Dragunov with the bomb onto everyone. Do they have the damage to finish skills? The answer is yes, as down goes Viper, and Dragunov has his moment in the sun. It's time to shine, baby, as he grabs himself to scout the last man standing. But Top Esports blow this game open.
And that's the thing. 369 said, you know what? I feel like we can fight this one. Had that angle to be able to jump into the back line, and it seemed disastrous. It seemed like it was all doom and gloom because 369 was all by himself, but he is so damn tanky. There's no way to be able to kill him fast enough, especially when you have a shield like that Haymaker shield he got, and it looks like they're just gonna go for the end.
If there's any team that'll do it, it's Top Esports. They brute force finish the game right here. EDG are respawning. Can they defend Top Esports? Onto the Nexus as EDG run out of the fountain, but there's too little and too late. Top Esports take the series 2-1.
And that's what you expect.